One New York City business leader says it is imperative to reopen the city by Labor Day to save the economy. But is it a realistic request?
Well, joining us now, David Bahnsen, the managing partner of the Bahnsen Group. Mr. Bahnsen, thank you for being with us this morning.
Thanks for having me.
So you wrote a letter to 25 CEOs and business leaders, in part talking about the downstream effect if we continue to stay closed, in essence. Talk about the Cliff Note version of the letter and your basic concerns.
Yeah, the point I was trying to make in the letter is not just the impact to the business of JP Morgan or the business of Blackstone, but to the businesses around our city, to all the restaurants, dry cleaners, the coffee shops, the different downstream impact that would have, that would be had if we reopen the businesses, if we start inviting employees to come back to work. Now, the obvious response would be, wait a second, what about the health and safety of the employees of these companies?
Right.
And my argument is that if anyone is in a suitable position to bring people back and provide logistically for their safety with distancing, with appropriate hygiene, with all the sort of CDC recommendations for how to do it safely, it's the wealthiest, largest, most resourced organizations and companies in the world. These entities have every ability to bring people back safely. What they need is the will.
And you talked about comparing it to the response from 9/11, how you can't allow to cower, in essence.
I believe that with every ounce of breath in my body, and I particularly believe it as it pertains to New York tough and the culture that defines this city. From Hurricane Sandy to the financial crisis to 9/11 to every event that the city has had to go through, it has not only survived, but it has thrived out of it. And COVID is going to be one of those things. If I happen to find the leadership of the city and the mayor's office to be a little lacking, I don't want to feel the same way about the top business leaders in the world, many of which, of course, run their companies.
So let me ask you something, Mr. Bahnsen. You know, you're saying we don't have much leadership here in New York City. I don't think too many people would disagree with you. But what kind of reaction have you gotten from the business leaders that you sent this letter to?
You know, what's interesting is that the bulk of the reaction I'm hearing is people sort of being surprised, like, oh, you really think it would be okay? You think the employees would like to come back? There's kind of this assumption out there that everybody's in inertia. And what I think everybody's looking for is leadership. I think someone needs to go out and buck the trend and say, okay, we're going to go first. We're bringing people back. We want to patronize the businesses that are around our tower, our skyscraper. We want our employees coming back to work. And I believe that what you'll get is people starting to follow. There'll be a momentum effect because everybody knows that the energy and life of the city depends on people being present.
It's so true because, I mean, this city is such a different city when you walk around right now between the homeless and the crime and empty areas. Midtown is desolate. Do you think some of these business leaders are afraid that they're going to get sued by their employees? We live in a very litigious society right now.
Well, I definitely think that there's a worry about liability protection. I think it's one of the reasons why the White House and the Senate Republicans are determined to have that be part of the next stimulus bill. But here's the number one way you avoid getting sued. It's following CDC guidelines. They can tether their employees back in. They can phase them in. They can also have them sign various waivers. But if you do the right distancing, look, I reopened my business after 4th of July, our presence here in Midtown Manhattan. The elevators are all, you know, set in a certain way. There's plexiglass. You can do what you need to do to protect people. There is how you go about avoid getting sued. I don't think that they have to worry about that because of the resources and their capabilities to avoid any kind of health risk whatsoever. The data right now in New York looks like a small town in Alaska as far as new cases and hospitalizations and mortalities. The rest of the country, when I share with them the data, what we're seeing here, they don't even believe me. Going a couple days at a time with no new mortalities, minimal hospitalizations, we are ready to go back to work.
You're right.
We are.
We want to know if anybody signed up.
I will let you know and come back on as soon as I hear from Jamie Dimon that J.P. Morgan is going to refill their towers. But all I want is the pressure to be out there and almost sort of the permission for people to say, you know what, Labor Day is a better target than New Year's Day.
I agree.
But a lot of people have become so comfortable now working from home also. You know, that's a factor. All right, David Bahnsen, thank you for being with us this morning. Let us know if you hear back from those other leaders.
Will do.
All right, have a good one.